So what a start for the number one seed, Jan or Jorgensen. One match played, one win. And the reason he's ahead of Tian Haowei is because he won by a bigger margin of his two straight games. Tian Haowei beat Mark Schwiebler, the two left-handers there, battle of the left-handers, 21-15, 21-7. So Jorgensen top of the group at the moment. But the next match features the number two seed. There he is, Sung Wan Ho of Korea, up against the four-time former champion, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia. While they wait in the wings, of course, that's our next match, that men's singles, and obviously from Group B with the number two seed. And then after that, we will have the Olympic silver medalists in the women's doubles. The Danes, Camilla Rutajul and Christina Pedersen, won this title 3 years ago when the event was staged in Kuala Lumpur. They're up against Malaysians in today's first match, Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei. And then we'll finish with women's singles. And the number two seed, Akane Yamaguchi, semi-finalist 2 years ago. She's up against the Olympic silver medalist, Pusala Venkata Sindhu of India. So plenty more action to come. But our next match features the number two seed, Sung Wan Ho of Korea, up against Lee Chong Wei. Sung Wan Ho, 28 years of age, and he's been in three Super Series tournament finals this year, hence his number two ranking on the Super Series. Lee Chong Wei, well, he just squeaked into the Super Series finals, ranked 8.
Singles, please welcome the number two seed from Korea, Sung Wan Ho.
Sung Wan Ho, the 28-year-old, won his first Super Series title actually in 2012 when he won India as an unseeded player. That was one of the surprises of the year in Super Series terms. And who did he beat in that final in Delhi 4 years ago? Well, none other than his opponent of today. There he is.
And please welcome his opponent, the current Olympic silver medalist and number seven seed from Malaysia, Lee Chong Wei.
Lee Chong Wei making his seventh appearance at the Super Series finals. 4 times he's won the title, 2008, 9, 10 and 2013. Winner of 3 Super Series titles this year. He's the most successful player across all 5 disciplines in Super Series history. He has a total of 44 Super Series titles. That is quite remarkable. So Hayditomo Kashihara from Japan, our umpire for this one. Well, he will go down in history, in my book, as one of the all-time greats, Lee Chong Wei, the 34-year-old born in Georgetown, Penang. He is the current world number one. 6 years running, he finished the Super Series year as number one on the Super Series standings. But this year, having played only 6 tournaments, he finished 8 on the Super Series list. But he's played just 9 tournaments this year. He's been in 6 finals. He's won 5 of them, including those 3 Super Series events. He is a huge supporter of the Super Series and has been over the years. He won the Malaysian Open for an 11th time. He won the Indonesian Open for a 6th time. The Japan Open this year for a 6th time, and now has those total of 44 Super Series titles. Remarkable. Well, his opponent is the number two seed, because Son Wan Ho, who's currently ranked number six in the world ranking, has been as high as four, a total of 11 weeks as number four. He finished the Super Series number two on the Super Series list, having participated in 11 of the 12 Super Series tournaments. He only missed the Australian Open, and he's been in three finals this year: the Singapore Super Series, the Korean Super Series, his home event, and also the Denmark Super Series as well. So three finals, that's very good consistency for the Korean from Changwon. So this is the 12th meeting between these two players, and the only time that Son Wan Ho has won was that India Super Series final 4 years ago that I was telling you about. The last time they met was in the group stage of the Thomas Cup, and that was earlier this year. Two straight games, as you saw. Four times, though, it has been the full distance, three games, as umpire Kashihara and Trish Gardner from New Zealand is our service judge.
Son Wan Ho, Korea. And on my left, Lee Chong Wei, Malaysia. Lee Chong Wei to South. Level play.
Oh, that was going wide, wasn't it? That's landed in.
Service over. One.
Well, if you look at the head-to-head, Steen, you've got to say that the current world number one, Lee Chong Wei, the former champion, has got to be overwhelming favourite for this. But Son Wan Ho is a player that I always think is capable of springing a surprise.
Yeah, I guess he is. He's not consistent. He's promised us so much, also from that Super Series win in India, and run into all kinds of troubles, and lost in Hong Kong Open recently to Hu Yun, whom we'd just seen on court, and that doesn't really bode well for him in this match. But we also don't know what kind of shape Lee Chong Wei will be in, because he's making a return after injury, lost to Brice Levardais in Denmark Open, and withdrew from, was it French Open he withdrew from?
Withdrew from the French, the China, where he was defending champion, and the Hong Kong, where he was defending champion. It's gone long.
Service over, 2-1.
Yeah, I did watch Son Wan Ho in Hong Kong. Yeah, I watched that match you were talking about against Hu Yun. And, of course, he was beaten by the better player on the day, but there was an incident which, at a crucial stage, which I don't think favoured the Korean. Mm. Ooh, that's gone wide. So I thought he was actually playing quite well, but the luck wasn't with him.
I had him as a little bit of a dark horse in the Olympics, but unfortunately for him, he met Chen Long very early in the tournament. Was it round of 16?
Yeah, it was actually the quarterfinals.
Quarterfinals, yeah.
But he was the only player in the tournament.
Took a set off and game off.
One.
Yeah.
And beat Chen Long at the Thomas Cup, where Korea knocked out China 3-2.
Yeah, and also had beaten him at the Asian Games men's team competition in 2014, and it meant that Korea took the men's team gold there. That was instrumental in both of those team competitions. Yeah. Oh, that's a good start, isn't it, by the number two seed.
Sheiks one.
Lee Chong Wei at the gala dinner on Monday evening was crowned the male player of the year for a fifth time. And I think that sums up, really, his longevity and his consistency over the years, doesn't it?
One.
Yeah, it does. And, I mean, he's also been a great supporter of the Super Series tournaments.
Yeah. Well, until 2014, he'd been in 36 consecutive Super Series tournament semi-finals.
2-7.
Roger Federer only made 23 Grand Slams.
Ah, okay, I thought because I hadn't noticed him in the Super Series.
I was just jumping from sport to sport there. Keep up, Steen.
Service over.
8-2.
What a fantastic
serve. 3-8.
Most players would have played that return of serve.
Look at
with
this.
A forehand, he plays it backhand and then just flicks it cross court. How do you do that?
It's a fun shot to practice, I can tell you that.
Service over 9-3. Service over
4-9.
Oh, 5.
Quite well placed, those two smashes.
Wasn't a bad lift either, was it?
No.
Which makes the smash even more impressive.
Service over 10-5.
I think it's impressive the way he's preserved his speed, his uncaught speed, Lee Chong Wei, throughout his career. Normally you get a little bit slower. It doesn't seem to be the case with him, but perhaps he is if you measure it, but it just seems so fast on court.
11-5, interval.
Well, it's a good start from the number two seed, so Wan Ho. 11-5, his advantage.
Twenty seconds.
Well, Lee Chong Wei is coach, number one.
Play.
World champion. I wonder what he's advised the world number one. Oh, that's good.
Service over.
Well, I actually don't know. because I'm sitting with this feeling that, hey, someone who has made a great start to this match, but all I'm waiting for is to see whether Chong Wei will sort of put a little bit more effort in it and get his game together and sort of stamp his mark on this match. And I probably will maintain that feeling until Stonewall gets 20 points. If he gets 20 points in this game, I feel it's up to Chong Wei. I have a reasonable idea about what's coming from Sun, but I feel that suddenly Chong Wei is sort of giving a little bit more gas.
What defense.
He looks like he's having fun, Chong Wei. There's all kinds of deceptive shots here.
12-7.
That's, of course, really, really nice for us to watch, but
yeah.
It's not always the most efficient way of playing.
But do you think that may be a sign that he's a little bit nervous, that he's deliberately trying to relax himself by playing some fun shots? Mm. Obviously
I haven't
not.
Really thought
no.
about that, but that's a very good that's a very good idea. Never thought of that.
13-7.
There's a difference between physically fit and match fit, isn't there? And that
there
missed net shot there is an indication to me that he's not match fit.
Yeah.
Because you haven't quite got that touch.
I have a little bit the same feeling I had when we saw the Carolina Marin Sun Yu match, that Sun Yu, and in this
15,
case here, Sun Ho is the more reliable player, that if he can make the rallies long, then eventually Lee Chong Wei will make mistakes.
Service over 8-16. Service over 17-8.
There might also be some kind of emptiness inside Lee Chong Wei. I mean, he's won a silver at the Olympics for the third time in a row. So what's next? What's his next goal?
Yes, I think that's
19-8.
Good point, because been world number one for so long. He's, yeah. You know. I guess the World Championships next year
the
is...
The World Championships in Glasgow. But there's so long still until the World Championships is only next year.
Yeah. That's gone wide.
20.
So game point opportunities.
Game point 8.
For the number 2 seed, Sun Wan Ho.
Service over, 9-20.
Park Tae-sang, Korean coach. Oh.
Gay.
And the opening
game. First game won by Song Wan Ho, 21-10.
21-10 confirms the umpire. The number two seed really outclassing the former champion, four-time former champion in that opening game. Well, it's remarkable to me that Song Wan Ho is looking so fresh because, of course, just a couple of days ago, he won the Korean Grand Prix gold in Jeju. And from there, he needed a flight to Seoul. And from Seoul, he needed a flight to here, Dubai. And that was his first title for over 2 years since winning the Hong Kong Super Series at the end of 2014.
He's fired up.
And he's fired up. He's ready.
But he's also played a lot of tournaments lately, like we discussed with Hu Jin, and here it seems to have the totally opposite effect.
Okay. 20 individual tournaments this year. Just emphasizes your point. Lots of events for this man.
Yeah, I guess 20 events is in itself reasonable enough, because I mean, if you're a professional badminton player, playing 20 out
seconds.
Of 52 weeks doesn't seem like a lot. So the only thing we have to bear in mind here is that it's an Olympic season, and almost all the players involved in the Olympics with a shot at a medal sort of built everything around that event.
Play.
So what can the four-time former champion Lee Chong Wei do in response to that?
Service over, one love. Two love.
Wow.
Service over.
That was
one, two.
Decision, I think.
Yeah.
Two
another all. Accurate smash from Song Wan Ho.
Service over, three,
forced the short
two.
Lift by the quality of the net play, Lee Chong Wei. Where is Vita? About half court. That's always an indication of how deep the lift was when the player playing the overhead. Where do their feet land?
Service over, 3-3.
And the good thing when you're coming directly off a tournament win is that you definitely have self-confidence and match practice. Touch should be there as well, even though it's a new hole. Played a lot of matches and hurt. The words 20 match point while you're holding the shuttle in your hand, that's always a good thing.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
5-3.
And he's playing really well, someone who I feel that what Lee Chong Wei is doing here would be enough against a number of other players, but against someone Ho here, he's just really, really consistent, and so far he's had the upper hand in this match.
Three. Service over.
Frame of the racket.
4-5.
Setting up an easy kill for the world number one.
Quite old.
Good use of the body smash.
Service over.
Control that, because the shuttle was spinning from Lee Chong Wei.
Yeah, you can often hit a total miss hit and get it on the blue carpet.
7-6.
Very satisfying, Coach Park Tae-sang. Oh, that's brilliant. Oh, that's on that line.
8-6.
Well, there's a similar backhand played off the flick serve that we saw in the previous match.
Lai Chu-yun.
Oh. Ah. 9-6.
Four straight points to Song Wan Ho.
Service over. 7-9.
walked us players put you coaches through.
Yeah, and we always have the better solution afterwards.
Misjudgment.
Eight,
that would
nine.
Confirm our theory on the left to right drift as well, wouldn't it?
At least support it.
Support it, yeah. Thought it was going wide, but it came back in.
Yeah.
Perfect net shot. Oh dear.
Service over.
We saw Marie miss one of those big opportunities as well, and that's often what happens in the first rounds of tournaments, where you're a little bit still not adapted to the hole. As we come further into the tournament, we see less and less of these mistakes. And of course, this is a special tournament because you face so tough opposition from the beginning. Normally you don't meet a seeded player if you're seeded yourself, and here we have the eight best players, so you could say that we start in the quarterfinal stage for a regular tournament.
What a good rally. Oh, goodness. Oh, it's just a challenge.
Yeah,
there's a challenge.
So
here
for challenge. Called out.
Well, I thought it was just wide, but you're in a slightly better position than me.
I think I saw something white on the line. It might have been the feathers.
Let's see what Hawkeye say.
Yeah, it was the feathers.
Well done, line judge. He's out.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 9-0.
It's the first challenge of this men's singles, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And unintentionally, I think someone who is in risk of playing Lee Chong Wei into form. That's what he needs. More of these rallies here. Oh, that was wide.
Yeah.
10-9. Service over, 10-0.
And very, very revealing to me that after that rally, there's a little clench of the fist from Song Wan Ho. He rarely shows any emotion, and that's possibly about as excited as you'll ever see him get.
Yeah, he feels he's got a good chance of winning this match.
Yeah. Certainly got the advantage. Game up. 11-10 up here in the second.
Twenty seconds. Coach. Thank you, coach.
Well, there's definitely something about moving Lee Chong Wei from side to side, maybe deep corner to deep corner. I wasn't sure about those gestures there, but
play.
Obviously some sort of tactical advice from Park Tae-sung. Oh, that's down the line. That's a good play.
Service over. 11 all. Service over, 12-11.
No, the court will need to be mopped. Lee Chong Wei putting his hands down on the court surface, and that always leaves a bit of perspiration on the court, which can make the court a little bit slippery.
Thank you. Play.
Missed it.
Service over, 12, all.
I just sense, Steen, that from the Korean's perspective, he's got to keep this really, really tight, because it's almost as if I'm just waiting for Lee Chong Wei suddenly to up the pace and win us three or four points and get a bit of a lead.
I do too. I do too, but I'm not sure it's going to happen. I think someone who has a great chance of winning it, but I think, like you, that he's got to win it in two games. On the other hand, it spells a little bit of trouble for Chong Wei, as he's obviously not in his best form, and the two other players in this group, they're gonna get some hope from watching this match, and there's not gonna be any respect points to Chong Wei. By that I mean that
I'm
a bit afraid of your opponent when it's Chong Wei, and thus he gets a couple of easy points in every match. I don't think there's gonna be any of those in the next 2 days.
No.
They're going to smell blood. But it might end up being their own in the end.
Oh. 14-13.
Yeah, that's good judgment.
Well played.
Service over. 14.
And it's a fine balance he's got to find, Sun Wan Ho, between not getting too eager to finish this match off, and also not getting too passive. And I mean, he's definitely got an advantage when the rallies get longer. So not being too passive in order just to wait for the long rallies. Very, very fine balance there. Very easy point. We almost never see Chong Wei make that kind of mistakes.
Service over. 15-all.
Next few points are crucial. I can just sense it.
Yeah. It's first to six from here.
Service over.
My goodness me.
16.
Now, I
15.
Remember just a couple of rallies ago from that round the head position, he played cross court.
Yeah. The variation is so important.
It is.
It's a little bit short from Chong Wei, and I have a feeling that there might be a little bit of drift coming from Sun Wan Ho's side towards Lee Chong Wei and the side that we're sitting on. But the question is, like the match with Carolina Marin, where we saw she was able to play better towards the end of the second game, when the match was at stake, she played good rallies, she played much better than the rest of the match. She ended up losing anyway, but she survived, what, 8-9 match points. If Chong Wei can do the same, he's much closer to Sun Wan Ho than Marin was to Sun Yu.
Down the line again.
18, 15.
3-point advantage and 3 points away from recording only his second ever victory over Lee Chong Wei.
Yeah, that would be a really, really big surprise to me, even though you could say the pace that it could happen, Chong Wei coming off an injury break and someone who coming off a victory, but it's very surprising to me anyway. But he's played very, very solid, Sun Wan Ho.
He's done it again.
19.
One cross,
15.
One straight on the winning smash, and now cross court again.
And I think the lifts are a little bit too short. Not much from judging
19,
from his
15
position of his feet. Sun Wan Ho. Wow.
20. I think it was 15 all when I said the next
15.
Few rallies will be crucial. My goodness, I didn't think it would be 5 straight points from that point to this match point. 5 match point opportunities.
Oh.
I don't believe it.
Oh.
Challenge it. Well,
Sun Wan Ho challenge.
It was called out.
Out.
Well, this match point opportunity, there was an extraordinary net exchange. And what appeared to be a simple kill for Sun Wan Ho, it was awfully close to the line, I know that. It was called out. What does Hawkeye say? Here we go. Oh, it was out. Well, no challenges left.
Successful. No challenge remaining. Service over. 16.
The lifeline, so for Lee Chong Wei.
It is, it is.
Play.
We've had a lot of good line calls here on difficult shots.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh.
the four-time former champion and current world number one in this opening Group B match for these two players. Only his second ever victory.
21-10.
Over Lee Chong Wei in their 12th meeting. And how well he played. Well, two straight games, 21-10, 21-16 in a match lasting just over 38 minutes. Well, my goodness me. We've had upsets galore on day one of competition here from the Super Series finals. Song Wan Ho, the number two seed, were living up to his billing. What a great match from him. Two straight games over the world number one. Well, this really puts a very interesting complexion on this Group B. But what a victory for Song Wan Ho. Great start for the number two seed, Song Wan Ho, beating the four-time former champion, Lee Chong Wei. Also in the group, of course, is one of the other players, just three players in the tournament to win a Super Series title this year, and that was Ankar Long. And he, along with Lee Chong Wei, the only two players to win home events this year on the Super Series. Victor Axelsen, the other player in the group, the Olympic bronze medalist. Well, the next match is women's doubles, and it's the Olympic silver medalists Christina Pedersen and Camilla Rutajul against Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei. So this is the fifth match today for us, this women's doubles, and then we'll finish with another women's singles. And the number two seed, Akane Yamaguchi, the 19-year-old, up against the Olympic silver.